Teams are fighting for playoff position. Seven teams will soon become four, and one of the teams that needs a win today is Avon facing Aragas in a crucial matchup. I'm Zando Arzamani, joined by Anthony Garib in the commentary booth today. Anthony, welcome.
Zando, thank you for having me. So excited to be here watching great basketball.
As you see the league standings, our men sit atop the table, still undefeated. Arta, 3-1 in second place. And Hrazdan, the defending champions, coming back and making a late season push after going on a two-game skid. They'll face the Armens later today. Pre-game season standings brought to you by LA Storm. And Anthony, today a lot of people missing for both sides.
Yeah, it's going to be shorthanded for Aragats. They don't even have their head coach, so I don't know how that's going to affect them. Derek Eliassi, top player for Aragats, will be missing. Avon, though, looks like they're going to be close to full. Should be a good matchup, but it's going to be a challenge for Aragats.
Absolutely. Good news for Aragats. Big Akokaluna is not here today for Avon. Coming off a 42-point performance, Anthony, he was magnificent last
week. Yeah, he's a huge player for their team. And I think that's going to make a big difference for them. They don't really have as much size without him. And I think that's a challenge when you have some of the players on Aragats. Should be a tight matchup, but Avon has that player that's really going to make a big difference if he was here.
Aragats still without a win this year, trying to get off the Schnei. Refs ready to tip it off. And the tip goes to Aragats. Kashishian brings it up. Selak Mukherjian matched up against him. Kashishian drives, pulls up, and gets his first shot to go. And Anthony, that's good news for him. He's been struggling to be efficient this year.
He's a mid-range maestro. When he gets up, it's tough to defend him.
Now Barsegian drives. Can't answer. Second effort, no good, and Winfrey pulls it down. On the break now, Aragats. Kalesian, quick move. Finds Winfrey inside, and Winfrey finishes.
Good look from Kalesian.
Barsegian with the ball. Another player missing for Avon today, Austin Cole. Lethal shooter out of Cal Lutheran. Barsegian gets to Gonzalez. And he's off, and Aragats putting their foot down early, Anthony.
Yeah, I think they've got to get out to a good start, and that's going to happen when you have five players.
Kashishian gets another one to go.
He jumps so high on that shot. It's so difficult to contest.
And you know what's the thing? When, as a defender, you have to be conscious of how high he jumps because it's easier to get under him.
Exactly.
Mukherjian off. Winfrey with another board. Kalesian pushes, pulls up, and Kalesian's 2-for-2.
Good move from Kalesian.
Early on, Aragats with an 8-0 lead. Avon gets it up the court. Gazigian thinks about it. Mukherjian. Barsegian drives. Winfrey's on him on the switch. Kalesian recovers. Gonzalez pulls up with the shot clock expiring. It's off.
Great defense from Aragats on that possession.
Kashishian. Off by Ava or Aragats. Quick pick or trigger from Mukherjian off, and Aragats doing great job cleaning up the boards. Kardosh inside, flicks it up, off. That's two misses in a row. Corner, Mukherjian wide open. He hits.
They needed that. You can't go down 10-0 early on. I think Aragats starting off to a good game, but I want to see how long they're going to last with five players. Are they going to get tired?
Fatigue definitely a factor with these 10-minute stop clock games. Double team goes towards Kashishian. Up top, Taronis. And Taronis hits a three.
Wow. I've never seen him hit a three.
You know what, sometimes when you're down to five guys, you got to do things you're not used to.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Mukherjian with it. Gets the screen.
That's a tough shot.
Rough start for him. That's a very tough shot. Kashishian steps back. Gets Mukherjian by him. Can't hit. It's his first miss of the night. Down the other way, Barsegian. Crafty move.
Nice finish. And I'm not just saying that because he's my cousin, all right? That was a good finish.
And that was much needed by Avon, slowly chipping away at this lead. Legend inside. He's off. Avon brings it down. Barsegian. Kirchin thinks about it. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Barsegian gets a man up. Inside, Garoyan can't control.
That was a good look. I think you got to get that down. But, I mean, I think Avon is getting into the game now. They started off slow, but they're getting into the flow right now.
And you know, Anthony, we talked about it before the game that they have Manuel Abulian, a very disciplined coach, at the helm.
Yeah, he wants to get the best shot possible. No cuts. You want to run the system. And I think they haven't really been doing that so far.
And there's Taronis hitting another three.
Second one I've seen him make, I'm telling you.
Arapetian checking in the game for the first time. Barsegian inside and finishes through two defenders.
Wow, tough finish. Nice little in and out move, quick step. Nice finish.
Shushin walking the ball up the court. Five to go in the first quarter. Aragats up 14-6. And Kashishin makes it a double-digit lead.
He just has such a quick first step. It makes him difficult once he gets in the mid-range.
Anthony, the last game he played in the ABA, he was 5 for 23. Tonight, starting very hot, going 3 for 4 to get things kicked off. And that'll be our first time out of the game by Avon. We'll be right back.
Last year was an eye-opening experience working out for five teams. So you know your hard work is what got you those opportunities. And I always said, I'll open the door for you, but you just got to do your part.
No, that's true. He it's funny because he told me that when I signed with him, he's like, look, I'm gonna get you in front of these doors. I'm gonna get you in front of NBA doors, no doubt. But once you walk into that gym, you gotta perform. I can't perform for you.
Lead for Aragats with 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. And Anthony, they've come out hot.
Yeah, Aragats has been shooting lights out, and I think I want to see how that's going to continue throughout the rest of the game.
Barsegian drives, gets Zorabi in the corner. Rebound Winfrey, he's been huge for them since joining this team.
Massive player, especially without Avon's top big man.
Kashishian, tough shot. Those are the shots you're going to have to live with as a coach. Ali Karamanian stepping into the helm for his father, BJ, today. Gonzalez can't hit.
They're getting good shots. They're just not hitting them.
And that's the thing for Aragats. You can't let these guys hang around. You got to start putting your foot down. Start letting them, taking them out of the game early. Inside, Winfrey working out of the post.
Oh.
An offensive foul called.
He laid that shoulder down. I can see it from here.
Great job by Gonzalez taking the contact, and now the ball back to Avon with the chance to make it a single-digit game. Arapetian gets it to Yazigian. He drives. Ooh. Foul called on Winfrey.
Interesting call.
That'll be the first foul on Winfrey today.
Fouls are going to be key, too. You got five players. You can't foul out.
No one to look at the bench and say, hey, you got to come get me.
Alec isn't going to suit up.
Kazigian misses the first. You know, Alec going from the went from a player to a commentator, and now he's on the sideline as coach. He's done every role you can imagine.
He's a GM too, right?
He's done everything you can imagine in this
NBA
league.
2K, my career.
3:45 left.
They're trying to
Kashishian inside. Avon on the break, Barsegian ahead of everyone. And it's an end one.
Wow. Hey, Ryan's came to play. On that pick and roll, though, they're trying to ice. And Kashishin's doing a good job of attacking Zarabi, slower on his feet. That, but it's just a bad pass on that one.
And Avon's done a great job getting off to the break. Kind of the opposite of what you'd expect. You just have to seem like Aragat's younger, fresher legs to get out on the break.
I think that's the key, though, because Aragat's only has five players. You got to try to tire them out. You see it a lot.
And that'll be the first timeout for Aragat's. Avon cuts it to a six-point lead. We'll be right back after the commercial break.
I mean, what's important for this upcoming season is just Gary being consistent and getting a chance to show what he can do and be on the court and all this hard work to pay off from where he started last year and kind of just keep evolving to where it's going. As we talk about G, it's about getting 1% better every day. I think that's what we need to just focus on.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Left in this first quarter of action. Aragats jumped out to an early lead, but Avon not staying quiet.
Yeah, Aragats went up 8-0. It's been basically a 10-6 run after that. Or no, 10-8.
Kashishin thinks about it, drives inside. Kardosh and one.
That's a tough play. That just hurts if you're Avon. They played pretty good defense. Just let that one slip at the last second.
And that's a run halting and one basket by Kardosh. And usually it's Aragats coming out on the short end of the stick height-wise, but today with Winfrey, with Taronis, with Kardosh, they're the bigger team.
Yeah, absolutely.
And Barsegian continuing his hot start. Anthony, I think he saw you in the booth and saw you have to do something
exactly.
Special.
He knew I was here. He said I have to show out.
Winfrey at the free throw line. Hits a man up in the air. And that's just easy.
That's a good move. I don't know how you stop that when that guy's coming at you.
Barsegian gets it up, off.
He's looking lively, though. He's feeling it.
Already with 9 points. The rest of the team only has three. It's triple from McCurchin. Kashishin loses the ball. Keeps it in the front court. And Winfrey jacks one up. Arapetian to Yazigian. Corner, Gonzalez. Gonzalez hits.
Big shot.
That one's a two. 7-point Aragats lead, two left in the first. Drive by Kalejian. Robbie called for the blocking foul.
Yeah, that's his second. I think he's gonna get sent to the bench.
You know, Kalejian, not the biggest guy, but I tell you, he's tough, and he ran through Zorabi
exactly.
Right there.
He's strong. He doesn't care. He's going to come right at you. He's got a fire in him, and that was tough right there. I mean, in that position, you can't really do much for the defender.
Garoyan in as well as Galaxy Caribbean.
It's my favorite name ever.
Collegian, 5 seconds on the shot clock. And he beats the buzzer and gets it to go. I'll tell you what, this Aragats team does not care today. They are not backing down from any challenge.
They're hitting some big shots at timely moments.
And Arapetian answers with a triple of his own. Kashishin pulls.
Ooh.
Tough shot. Rebound, Avon. Chance to make it a two-possession game. Corner, Caribbean. Arapetian behind the three-point line. Legend on the break. He's got Kashishian, and Kashishian takes it. Off.
That shot goes in 9 out of 10 times. And Kashishian knows it. He's a little perplexed.
No, as a shooter, you got to live with it.
Yep.
And he's gone off to a great start. You can't let that stay in the back of your mind.
Absolutely.
Only guy that started harder than him is Barsegian. He's with the ball. 8 on the shot clock, 38 on the game clock. Inside, and he's blocked by Kardosh. Shot clock violation, and that block just took down the Fanzia free throw cam.
The iPad just destroyed. I hope they had a warranty on that.
30 seconds to go in this first quarter. Aragas up 7. Kashishian almost loses it. 10 on the shot clock. Winfrey on Yazigian. Collection gets a man up.
Smart.
Draws a foul. He'll shoot 2.
That was such a smart play. All the eyes are on one player, and he just cuts right till the free throw line, gets it up, and smart pump fake, gets the foul. Collegian, I like Collegian. He's a good player.
Collegian off on the first. Anthony, you would think a team playing man down without their best player in Eliassi that they wouldn't be playing as well, but it seems like they played a more team brand of basketball today.
Absolutely. I think they're moving the ball well. They're hitting their shots, and they're playing pretty good defense. I think they've got Avon in a tough position to start off, and they've been riding that hot wave.
Legend 0 for 2 at the line, and Avon with a chance at the last shot. 5 on the game clock. Arapetian, he had a wide open lane, gives it up. Tyrone is half-court heave. He's off, and after one, it's Aragas up 7. We'll be right back with the Academy USA coaches. Academy USA Coach's Corner with Avon Coach Menwa Abulian. Menwa, you guys are missing Austin Cole and the Kokoluna. Who do you need to step up today?
Whoever steps up will take it. It doesn't matter who we're missing. Guys just got to step up behind them. We're also missing Mike and Blake, but all that is irrelevant at this point because no matter who's here, we play. We got more than enough. They got 6 guys. We got plenty, so we're good.
What's allowed Aragas to get out to this early lead?
They hit some nice, tough shots to start the game. We could have done a little better contesting them. But they hit a few tough shots, and then we started being a little over-aggressive and allowed to get them some more open looks. So they did a great job hitting those first few, and then that kind of set us back from there.
Thank you, Coach. Second quarter of action about to start. Today we got another great slate of AABA action. Aragas against Avon starting us off. A rematch of the finals from last year. Hrazdan versus the Armens. And to end it off, we have Artsakh and Erebuni. Avon's ball to start this second quarter. Down 7. Great defense by Collegian. Stays with Avon though. Yazigian in the post. Off, ball out of bounds, back to Aragas.
That's a tough miss. I think when you're that close, but he had 3 guys around him too. You know, it's easy to say when you're sitting down.
And Anthony, you know the thing, a team playing with 5 guys usually give up those layups. You can't afford to foul potentially, but Aragas has not backed down.
Yeah, exactly. They've been doing a good job of just contesting without fouling.
Winfrey drives. Powerful move, gets his own rebound. Up top, Kardosh. He's off. Collegian with the rebound. Third opportunity, and an offensive foul called on Winfrey. That's his second.
I mean, that's, he just laid his shoulder on him. Nothing else you can say about that, really.
My apologies. That actually is Winfrey's third, and that's trouble early on.
Third foul, 1 minute into the second. That's not good for Argots.
Already Westpaw's being wiped up. Anthony, you haven't been here a while, but that happens quite a lot.
I could imagine, you know, in every gym it always happens, especially with someone that just fell down like that. They don't have no sponsors on the floor cleaners? Not yet.
Plenty of great sponsors here in the ABA. LA Storm down there on the baseline. And Avon's going to inbound. And, you know, Avon, we've been mentioning it, they're getting good shots. They just can't hit.
Yeah, they're not hitting those shots. And I think that's really the difference in the game right now. Now Argot's in a 2-3.
The Garolian Caribbean. Hits a three.
That's a big shot. That's a big shot. Even if he can't hit it, now that makes the defense think twice.
Lead now down to four, and that zone's going to give Avon plenty of open looks from behind the arc. Collegian finds Winfrey, and Winfrey jams.
Wow. Nice cut. Good pass.
Winfrey like a pogo stick, just rising up and throwing it down.
That was easy.
Zizigian finishes over Winfrey.
Yeah, Winfrey did a good job of there. Just hands up. Don't do anything extra.
And as we mentioned, he has three fouls. He's got to be super careful.
Yeah, you have to be.
Legend to Kardosh. Off.
Whoa.
Barsegian coming back into the game after that hot first quarter.
Argots isn't happy about that call, and I get it.
Garolian, the one that hit the deck, slow to get up.
So it looks like when Barsegian is out, they're going to 2-3 zone. Now he's back in, they're going to a man. I think that's a pretty smart strategy, especially with five guys.
Arapetian brings. Corner Caribbean gets a man up in the air. And Kashishian, like a cornerback, intercepts.
Poor pass right there.
Goes the other way and lead back up to six.
This is bold. I thought that was going to be a full court press. Five guys? I don't know about that one.
Arapetian drives baseline. And Caribbean relocates, and he's wide open.
Sponsor sign just got destroyed.
Splatterhouse will be okay after that. Hopefully Toronto is okay after running into it.
That's more important, right?
Great pass across the court to Winfrey. And Winfrey throws it down again.
That was just easy.
The legend fired up, and Avon's going to need a timeout. They're down 8, 7:05 left in the quarter. We'll be right back. My Detroit players, Tim's from my hood again, in Brooklyn, land. Money, 7:05 left in the quarter, and The biggest story today is the biggest man for Avon missing. Akoa Kaluna not here today, coming off an efficient 42-point game. He was getting guys up in the air, drawing fouls, scoring inside, outside, getting rebounds. He was doing everything, and that's what Avon's missing today.
Yeah, I think if he was playing, it would have been great to see him against Winfrey. I think that's what they're missing right now. They don't really have anybody that could handle his physicality.
Now, as you mentioned, Anthony Aragot's back in man with Barsegian in the game.
Yeah, I think his three-point shot is too lethal.
Seven on the shot clock. Arapetian gets the high ball screen. Pulls up. That's off. Rebound Kardoš. Kashishian off one leg.
Oh, my. That's tough, man. What can you do in that position? You can't really do much.
And Kashishian, usually a deadly three-point shooter, doing a great job from the mid-range. Winfrey helps, and Kalegian's on the break. Arapetian's back. Kalegian with the acrobatic finish.
You know what? That was a good finish, but he could have thrown off the backboard. Nice alley-oop dunk.
And with the way Winfrey's been throwing it down these past couple of minutes, I don't mind that move.
It would have been nice.
McCurtain back in the game. Yazidjian takes one. He's way off.
Manuel doesn't like that one.
Kalegian.
Oh, my
makes
God.
Makes it a 15-point game.
What do you think the odds were before this? Anyone think this was going to happen with five players?
I'll tell you what. The betting line was definitely in favor of Avon. Aragas Live not looking too bad.
Yeah, not too bad. Hedging Henry would like it. You know Hedging Henry?
Gonzalez able to answer.
Good shot from there. You got to stop the bleeding.
And Avon just needs to stop at this point.
Yeah, they really do. Aragas is hitting some tough shots.
Kalegian. That one's off.
Felt like that was a heat check.
Gonzalez knocks down two in a row.
He's looking good today. His shot looks nice.
And he's getting in great spots. In flow, wide open, or open for him. Hand in the face doesn't mean hand in the face for certain players.
Tough shot, but he made it look easy.
Taronis gets the screen from Kardoš. Kardoš drives right into a man. It's called an offensive foul.
That's a bang-bang call, but I think it went the right way.
Anthony, I think that's the third charge Avon's taking today.
Yeah. They've been doing a good job of that, honestly, and I think that's smart, especially with a team with five players getting those charge calls. Because Avon can get into foul trouble. It won't make that much of a difference compared to Aragats.
Aragas doesn't have the luxury of having people to sub in if they get in foul trouble.
They can't pick anyone up from the street either. Who can they bring? They have nobody on the bench, so that's the
Anthony,
key.
You don't have shoes in your car? They might need you to suit
up.
Oh,
no, please. Never. I told you today, literally the first time I shot in like 2 months. And it's not like I have a shot anyways.
Five to go in this first quarter. Avon making it a single-digit game off that last possession. And it's thanks to this man, Rene Gonzalez. McCurtain. Six on the shot clock. Arapetian drives corner. Wide open McCurtain. And it's a six-point game.
That's huge. He was hesitant the first time. And if he gets that confidence and he's stroking it, that's a big, big piece of this offense.
Aragas now looking to respond to this run. Winfrey wants it in the post. He gets it. Spins. Gets it to the corner. Kalegian rises up and finishes. Counted at the foul.
That was nice. That was nice. Some shot clock cheese. That was a good finish. He rose up.
Went there amongst the trees and came up with 2 points.
That's a big basket, too, because Avon was getting some momentum.
Absolutely. They had three possessions in a row, hitting a triple. Shant trying to get 3 points the hard way. Converts the and one, lead back up to nine. Post Barsegian spins. Can't finish.
I'm surprised that's the first time they went to that matchup.
And Argos could make it a double-digit game again. Tyrone is short corner.
Good off-ball movement there.
McCurchin with it. Doesn't hand it off. Barsegian, he's been quiet in this second quarter.
That was a nice move. I'm surprised they hadn't gone to that matchup earlier with Collegian on him.
Barsegian heading back to the free throw line, and he's been doing great things for Avon, scoring inside. And he just plays a brand of basketball. He doesn't care who he's going up against.
Basically, yeah, he started off really hot, kind of slowed down, but he's always going to be aggressive. He makes smart plays, and he's a really underrated shooter. People don't know how good of a shooter he is, because I've seen him make in a game. He had about 5 threes in a row in a span of 2 minutes.
Splits the free throws. Winfrey keeps it alive for Aragats. Collegian the other way. Bumps into Irabetti and no foul call. Avon on the break. Barsegian to the corner. McCurchin. Short rebound. Barsegian might have traveled.
Ooh, that was close.
Gets away with one. And Garoyan shaking up. Yazigian coming in for him. Avon, every time you're expecting them to be out of the game, comes down and gets a tough basket.
Yeah, they're staying in it. And that's the key, I think, because it'll pay off in the long term.
Play stopped. Another wet spot down there. Anthony, offensively, both these teams have been great. But for Avon, what do they need to do defensively to start clamping down?
Honestly, I think they've been doing a good job. They just kind of lose at the last second. They lose a player. Someone gets open, and Argos gets an open look. They've been hitting some tough shots, too.
Shishin off on a tough one right there. Barsegian inside. Corner McCurchin.
Yeah, they missed him. He was open.
Five seconds on the shot clock. Gonzalez got to get something up. Avon keeps the possession alive. Barsegian. He's off.
Yeah, he started off really hot. He just cooled down.
And credit to Aragas doing a great job on these second and third defensive possessions, not losing focus and getting the rebound. Shishin, he'll go to the line now.
That's just so tough to defend because you're basically in his space no matter what, and he just rises up.
He's got that floats when he's in the air.
He jumps so high. It's insane. Like, I don't know how. It's like, have you seen that video of Michael Jordan jumping? This vertical is crazy. I'm not saying Greg is Michael Jordan, but it reminds me of that.
I'll tell you what, he'll want to be compared to Kobe before Jordan.
That's true. Don't tell him I said that.
Minute 45 to go here in the first, or his first half. Shishin makes it an 8-point game.
Avon's offense has really just slowed down the last couple minutes. It was a 6-point game at one point, or 4-point game.
And the smile from Shishin, happy about his performance so far. Irapetian. He gets it back inside Barsegian. McCurchin's wide open. And that's off.
You live with that if you're Argos. Get it out of Barsegian's hands.
Winfrey almost loses the handle. Gonzalez guarding him. And Winfrey can't finish through him. Thought he was going to get a foul call.
That was good one-on-one defense, honestly.
Barsegian with it in the post. McCurchin finds it again.
Gotta go quick.
It's the matchup Anthony likes. Barsegian. No finish. 45 left in this first half. Collegian with it. Inside to Kashishian. He's got 12 points. And Taronis gets stripped. Winfrey lines up with it and winds up with 2 points.
That's what's been happening this first half. They play good defense. Something like that happens. Ball gets loose. They don't get it.
Not playing through the full possession.
Yeah, exactly. Kind of just sleeping
Winfrey,
through.
Winfrey, right place, right time.
Absolutely.
Arabetian holding for the last shot of the quarter. And Taronis gives one.
Smart. I think that was a tough matchup in that position. Now 6 seconds left.
6 seconds to go, and they still got another foul to give. Never mind. They're out of fouls to give. Caribbean will trigger. Into Arabetian. Barsegian. Off, and that'll do it for the first half. Aragas coming out of the gates, shocking everyone, taking a 10-point lead early. Halftime coming right now, but we'll be right back.
Last year was an eye-opening experience working out for 5 teams. So you know, your hard work is what got you those opportunities. And I always said, I'll open the door for you, but you just got to do your part, you know?
No, that's true. He it's funny because he told me that when I signed with him. He's like, look, I'm gonna get you in front of these doors. I'm gonna get you in front of NBA doors, no doubt. But once you walk into that gym, you gotta perform. I can't perform for you.
my Detroit players. Tim's for my hooligans in Brooklyn.
I mean, what's important for this upcoming season is just Gary being consistent and getting a chance to show what he can do and be on the court, and all this hard work to pay off from where he started last year and kind of just keep evolving to where it's going. As we talk about G, it's about getting 1% better every day. I think that's what we need to just focus on.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
Second half of action about to get kicked off. Aragas getting off to a crazy hot start. 10-point lead at the half. Anthony, you're new here, so let me break it down. We need our Armenian sniper halftime report.
I'll give it to you quickly. Look, Avon needs to go on a run. It's about as simple as that. Every time they've got on a mini run, Aragas has answered. I think they've got to see if their shots are going to fall. I want to see also, is Aragas going to get fatigued? First half is over. They have no subs. We've talked about it already multiple times. So will they get fatigued? Can Avon go on a nice, sustained run? That's the key for me.
And the big thing for Aragas, they're not getting it done from behind the three-point line. Only four triples up until this point, and two of them coming from Taronis.
They're running a good offense.
They have not missed a beat with Alec Karamanian stepping in for his father, BJ. Second half not off to a good start for them as they're off. Mkhitaryan finds Barsagian. Kalegian playing up on him. And there's a steal. Kalegian on the break. Gonzalez is back. And another acrobatic move to
finish. Nice finish right there.
We were talking about Kashishian hanging in there. Kalegian's a guy that hangs too.
Okay, if Kashishian's hangers like Jordan, Kalegian's like Kobe.
We talked to Greg about that at halftime.
Yeah,
he's still
going to
want that to be switched. Barsagian with the free throw line pull-up.
On offense, they just look a little stagnant. I don't know what it is. It seems like there's not really a lot of flow on that side.
I think the big thing, they're not taking that first shot that's open. They're trying to be a little too unselfish and keep moving the ball.
Yeah, I think that's probably one of the problems.
Winfrey with it. And Kashishian launches, can't hit.
That's a shot he hits. It's just tough when it doesn't go in.
Barsagian off on his triple. Anthony, call me Gracie, but I think Greg is a better contested shooter than open shooter.
Absolutely. I 100% agree with that. It makes no sense, but it's true.
Kalegian almost goes up and comes back down, gets the pass off, and there's Barsagian getting a steal.
That was a really nice move from Kalegian.
Arapetian pulls up. No good. Avon, they're the ones called out of bounds.
I don't know what to think about that. 3-on-1, pull up for a three.
Not a move you usually see out of Arapetian, a much more disciplined player.
Yeah, I think that's a little bit more of trying to cut it to the deficit.
Legend has it. 9 on the shot clock. Aragats in no rush in any of these possessions in the second half. Kalechian pulls up. Off back iron. Gonzalez. That's his third triple of the game.
He's been hot all day. That's one guy you can't lose right now.
came back into the single digits. Winfrey, the high flyer. Up top, Kardosh. Answers with a three-pointer of his own.
That's a tough matchup, though, Winfrey against Gonzalez. He can basically attack the basket every time. Smart move to just kick it out for the open three.
And it's what we've been talking about all game. Every time Avon starts to fight back, Aragas has an answer. Gershon inside, Yazidjian draws a foul.
Fourth on Winfrey, right?
I believe so. Ref calls it on 24. That's going to be on Kashishian. It's a big break for Aragas.
Yeah, that's huge. Didn't look like that possession was going to end well, so get some points out of this one.
A big miss by Yazidjian. You cannot be giving up missing free throws. You need every point you can get at this stage of the game.
Yeah, they've been shooting poorly from the free throw line, and that's not going to end well unless he misses the second. Basically, an empty possession right there.
Now, Aragas with the chance to extend their lead. Kashishian drives, hook shot, and he banks it in.
What the hell? I didn't know he had that in his game.
I don't think anyone knew yet. I don't think he knew he had that in his game.
I wish I never saw that.
Aragas now up 12. Hand off Barsegian. Barsegian off. And Aragas clamping down on defense in the second half. Kashishian. Reverse lay, no good.
Whoa.
Foul called on Avon Winfrey with four defenders around him.
Almost wasn't even enough. But on that play, Greg had the open. He had the open guy near the dunker spot. Just missed the pass. But he's playing with a lot more energy right now after that sky. I'm still not over that sky hook. Can we call that a sky hook or junior sky hook?
That was like a sky hook to third, I think.
Yeah, that was. And he banked it too, running off to the side.
Look, I've seen Greg hit some tough shots. I've seen him hit a lot of off-balance shots.
I've never seen him do that. But that just shows he's playing with a lot of confidence, which isn't good for Avon.
Confidence? And he just seems so comfortable in this game.
Yeah, very comfortable, at ease. And that's not a good look, because then he's going to start pulling up from almost half court, and that's when it gets dangerous.
And Aragas getting everyone involved, making sure everyone touches the rock, everyone's scoring. Possession now goes to Avon. Anthony, three guys in double figures for Aragas so far, and there's three guys you would expect. Kashishian, Winfrey, and Kalegian all with. Dreyer has 12. Kalegian has 13, and Kashishian with 14, and he's about to make it 16.
He was trying to dunk that one.
We were talking to him at halftime. We're like, Greg, you got to throw one down. Played it safe, got the layup, extends the lead now to 14, and forces Avon to call another timeout. Commercial break coming, but we'll be right back.
Last year was an eye-opening experience working out for five teams. So you know your hard work is what got you those opportunities. And I always said I'll open the door for you, but you just got to do your part.
No, that's true. He it's funny because he told me that when I signed with him, he's like, look, I'm gonna get you in front of these doors. I'm gonna get you in front of NBA doors, no doubt. But once you walk into that gym, it's you gotta perform. I can't perform for you.
5.5 minutes left in this third quarter. Aragaz shocking everyone with a 14-point lead. And Anthony, I think there's one man we could attest it to, and that's Greg Shishin.
Yeah, he just seems more comfortable in this second half. Obviously, he had a good start to the game. And then he kind of cooled, wasn't playing real well. But now he's starting off this half strong. And that's the key, I think, for them. If he gets involved offensively, it just makes him so tough to defend because you have to deal with Collegian, deal with Winfrey. And Kashishin is just a sniper.
Kashishin not getting it done from behind the three-point line. He's actually has no triples on this game.
And that's scary because then he's bound to hit one and then he's going to get hot.
Groyan gets it back to Irapetian. Groyan finishes over the defenders.
That's a good offensive possession after the timeout.
I think that's just a much-needed basket.
Yeah, huge.
And Aragat's not trying to get this game's pace sped up. Yeah, obviously, they had that break where Kashishin was open, besides that, walking the ball off the court. And Winfrey goes inside.
It's just so difficult to defend when he's coming straight. I mean, what do you do?
He's like a hybrid player. You can play him at the forward. You can play him at the center. You can even play him at guard if you really need to.
And he's doing a good job of just taking his time, taking what defense gets him or gives him. That's what's the key right now for Aragat's.
After the fancy free throw cam getting taken down in the first quarter, it's back up. Great job by our technical team. Had to be George Kachajian getting that one fixed.
Shout out, George.
Producer Anthony Abachi trying to take credit for it, but George not going to be happy. Ball in to Irapetian. Aragaz lead back up to 13. Irapetian right inside, up top, Yazigian. Doesn't hit, Groyan rebounds off the rim. Third chance now, Gonzalez. Irapetian drives four on the shot clock, corner, and Galaxy Caribbean hits it.
Big shot. Aragaz is playing just outstanding effort on defense.
If they could limit these second chance points, this game would be a 20-point game.
Oh, yeah.
Winfrey now sets a screen. Collegian gets it to Kardosh. Kardosh off from mid-range. And Alvon starting to pick up the pace. Irapetian makes it an 8-point game.
That's two big baskets for them. Now they're getting some momentum. Let's see how Aragat's response.
And I'm surprised they haven't gone to more of a high pick-and-roll action with Winfrey. Maybe force a switch and just have someone make a play.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Winfrey inside to Kardosh. And Aragaz, before that shot, were shooting nearly 50% from the field. Irapetian steps back. Off rebound, Winfrey. Other way, Kashishian.
If that shot went in, Aragaz had to take a timeout.
For now, it's still Kashishian with the ball. Can't knock it down. Rebound Kardosh. And a foul called on Garoyan.
Alvon's been playing with a smaller lineup the whole game, and I think that's really what's impacting them at times, those second chance balls.
Guy like Kaluna not being here, 6'7 frame. Just a guy that the ball's anywhere near him, he's going to get that rebound. He plays with so much heart and tenacity.
That's been a big difference so far. I think just with not only that, but just his defense on Winfrey, and they haven't really been dominating the paint at all.
Corner Kashishian. Still can't hit from deep.
He's going to keep shooting, though. He's got a short memory.
Absolutely. As the great Ted Lasso says, you got to be like a goldfish. Now Gonzalez finds Irapetian. Avon still down 8. Corner Caribbean. That's his second
big
one from
shot.
That spot. You know, a guy like Galaxy Caribbean, you can't count him out. A sniper from deep. Kashishian can't answer, and Winfrey cleans it up.
And that's what I was saying. They don't have that presence on the inside. Winfrey could basically get an offensive rebound whenever he wants.
Caribbean can't hit. And Winfrey gets a huge rebound. He's off to the races. Collegian. Huge triple puts them back up 10.
Great answer from Aragon. It's just perfect.
And just when Aragos looked like they were going to fade, they come back and put their lead back up to 10. Gonzalez drives. And I'm surprised Avon hasn't put Barcelian back in the game.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on over there.
Winfrey tips it to Collegian.
Winfrey looks tired, though.
Unfortunately for him, he has no one to come in.
Yeah, no one to help.
Collegian. Floats one up and
in. Wow, Collegian is going crazy. That's such a tough finish.
It just seems like they're having a different guy take a turn every single time. It's Shishian, then it's Collegian, then it's Winfrey.
That's what's making them so difficult to defend right now. They've got so many answers on the offense.
Iropetian.
Whereas Avon is just really struggling to get anything.
Doesn't seem like Avon has that guy they can lean on down the stretch. Usually they have Austin Cole, a lethal shooter, or Kaluna, who just backs guys down. But today they don't have that. They don't have that luxury.
Yeah, they really don't. I think that's been one of the differences. Aragas is able to lean on any of those three players we've talked about to get a bucket. It's been not. It just hasn't been like that for Avon.
Barsegian driving, pulls up, and off again.
Yeah, he was forcing that a little bit.
3-on-3 break, Collegian. Carlos driving back to the basket. And shot jacks one up. Winfrey with another board. Kashishian can't bank it in. Aragos with 3 or 4 chances on that possession. Arapetian driving, 30 seconds left in the quarter.
Oh, too much unselfish there.
And that's what we've been talking about.
They had two basically wide open threes. Like, I get if it's Curry and Klay Thompson, but you gotta take one of those.
Anthony Winfrey is killing it right now. 15 points, 14 rebounds. He's left his imprint on this game.
He's just been everywhere. I mean, whenever they need a key play, he's made it. Not only on offense, but defensively getting rebounds. But he looks gassed right now.
8 seconds on the shot clock. Caribbean, one of the bright spots so far today. Barcelian drives, and that's a huge 2 points.
If you can got to stop here, get some momentum. That's going to be important.
5 seconds to go on the quarter. Kashishian gets it up. Can't hit his first. Ricardo can't follow it up. And Aragas keeping this 10-point lead alive going into the final quarter of action. Academy USA Coaches Corner coming right now. You're at Academy USA Coaches Corner with Aragats head coach, Alec Karamanian. Alec, what's allowed you guys to get out to this 10-point lead headed into the fourth?
Man, guys are playing fast, playing aggressive. Only 5 guys, but they're all going hard, man. I love it.
Alec, obviously you're filling in for your dad, BJ. What would he want to say to the team right now going to this last quarter?
They're a young team. They've lost leads before. Just stay in it. You know, they're going to make a run again at some point, so just stick with it.
Thank you, Alec. Final quarter of this opener today, coming right now. Final quarter of action, 10-point Aragats lead. 10 minutes to go. Aragats looking to hang on for their first victory of the year. Anthony, what's Avon got to do to make a run?
Look, they've got to get into some flow offensively. I mean, nothing has been going easy for them. I think it starts on the defensive side. You've got to push the pace. This is a five-player team. You've got to push the pace. They're already kind of winded. I think last 10 minutes, I wouldn't be surprised if they start to push it a little bit more here, but they just have to get into some flow offensively.
Maybe even potentially starting to press, just something to speed up this game.
Something. You gotta switch it up a little bit here, and Coach Manoa is an expert at that, so he'll do it.
Talking to Coach Alec at the end of the quarter, he said it. It's a young team. They've blown leads before, and that's not out of question right now. Caribbean can't get things kicked off for Avon. Aragats continuing to slow down this game. Let precious seconds come off the clock. Winfrey hands it off to Kashishian. Kashishian continues to hit from mid-range.
That's his shot. That really is.
Kashishian has just been lights out today from mid-range. Inside Barsegian. Off one leg. Big shot.
He's got to get into some flow, too. He started the game really hot, and he's just not been the same since.
I think you might have to go with him as that guy that's scoring these baskets down the stretch in this last
quarter. Have to, especially with Collision, with all the respect. He doesn't have the same mass as Barcelian in the post.
You know, got to give credit to Aragats, running some great sets. Kashishian airballs a floater.
Some contact on that. Kashishian doesn't like it.
Arapetian might have traveled. Gonzalez might have traveled as well, but it lines up being 2 points.
And he's got that over Winfrey.
And as you said, Winfrey gassed at the end of the quarter. That break, very essential for him.
Yeah, major.
Collegian inside with the left hand, can't finish. Cardosh not able to clean it up for him. And you could tell fatigue is just setting in for this whole team. Collegian finished a lot of layups like that early in the game, but towards the end, your legs are tired. Your brain starts getting tired, too.
Yeah, I think that's what you're seeing right now. If you're Coach Alec, you got to use these timeouts wisely now.
And Arapetian doesn't finish. And Aragats gets a break. Kashishian. That one's a two. Oh,
that's
still
such a tough shot. In and out move going to his left.
Arapetian gets the screen from Garoyan. Barsegian driving. And it'll be a goaltend on Winfrey.
Was that goal? I don't know if that was a goaltend.
What was that?
I don't know if that was a goaltend.
Look close. Refs say is final, so we're going to have to go with it.
We'll go with it. They're lucky we don't have instant replay. No coaches' challenges?
No coaches' challenges here.
Wow.
Might have to bring that up at the league meeting at the end of the season.
Smart, though. You know, less replays, better flow game.
Winfrey gets it to Taronis, and Taronis is blocked by Yazidian.
Haven't seen much from Taronis this game.
Besides those two threes early on, he's been quiet.
Big role on defense, though. He's been playing good on that side.
Barsegian with it in the post. Him and Kashishian know each other very well. Gonzalez way off. Kashishian setting the screen for Collegian. Kashishian has it. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Deep. And he finally hits one.
I'm telling you, he was bound to hit it, and what a deep, that's a big three, man. Cause
couldn't have come at a better time.
It just hurts your momentum on defense.
And now corner, McGurchian finds Barsegian. Barsegian gets blocked by Cardosh.
Now Argos playing fast.
Kashishian inside, off the rim. Wow. And one basket
costly,
by Cardosh.
Costly foul there, and that's another offensive rebound for them.
Just like that, Avon had it at an 8-point game. blink of an eye, it becomes 13.
And when Kashishin is attacking like that, he's so difficult to defend because you just saw the acrobatic move he made. Great job getting that offensive rebound and getting the second chance.
Aragot saying, we don't care how many guys we got, 5, 6, 15. We're just going to go play our style of basketball. And today, Alvan hasn't had an answer for it.
Yeah, and I'm surprised they're really pushing the pace, too. And they're not really worried about this five-player stuff, which I get. You know, you're on the court, you're not thinking about it. But that's putting a lot of pressure on Alvan, too, which has just been getting kind of distraught after they missed those shots.
Barsegian drives. Can't get it to Zizian in the short corner.
Yeah, I get the idea on that pass. I think he had the mid-range, he had the shot, but you want to get your big man involved.
And Aragot's a basket here. We give them their biggest lead of the game. Collegian around Gonzalez and finishes.
That's just so, you literally can't do anything. You can't do anything with that.
Timeout called by Manuel Ava, or Aragot's bench fired up. Alec and Pat, the Karamanian brothers, getting the team into it. Timeout, but we'll be right back. My Detroit players, Tim from my hood again, in Brooklyn, land.
Last year was an eye-opening experience working out for five teams. So you know, your hard work is what got you those opportunities. And I always said I'll open the door for you, but you just got to do your part. You know?
No, that's true. He it's funny because he told me that when I signed with him, he's like, look. He's like, I'm going to get you in front of these doors. I'm going to get you in front of NBA doors, no doubt. But once you walk into that gym, you got to perform. I can't perform for you.
Aragot's out to their biggest lead of the game, up 16 with 5:47 left. Anthony, this is something no one expected.
Yeah, nobody, especially with this type of matchup. I think the key for Alvan right now is you've got to get some momentum. I wouldn't be surprised if they get into a full court press.
You got to score some quick baskets. Arabetian brings it up. Arabetian finds Garoyan. Garoyan runs into a wall, but he gets a foul.
And Aragot's, credit to them, they've been playing really good defense the entire game. You haven't really seen a letdown so far.
Two huge free throws, Anthony. We were talking about it earlier. A lot of missed free throws for Avon.
That hurts. And, you know, another miss right there. In a game like this, especially when their offense isn't flowing, you need those free throws. You just need those easy points.
And Garoyan 0-for-2 at the free throw line. That's another rebound for Winfrey. He's at 16.
He's been dominating the boards.
Winfrey. Shishin has it in the corner. Arapetian matched up with him. Shishin can't hit. Time running out on Avon's comeback hopes. Gonzalez hits another three.
That's what you need. He's been hot all game.
I'm surprised they haven't ran some more action for him, try to get him more involved.
Yeah, I think it's just been a struggle offensively just to get into their sets.
Collegian drives, steps through. Taronis finds Winfrey. Winfrey can't finish.
That's a tough finish.
And now Avon needs to be virtually perfect the rest of this way. Gonzalez scores inside the three-point line now.
He's been their spark offensively this entire game.
And he's usually more of a complimentary player, a 3 and D guy, but today he's really stepped it up.
Yeah, and that's been big because they really haven't seen a lot of offensive flow.
Short corner, Kardosh halts the run for now.
Honestly, you live with that if you're Avon. You live with that shot.
4 minutes to go now. Avon still down 13. Barsegian drives. 6 on the shot clock, gets it up and puts it in.
I thought he had that initially when he gave up his dribble. He could have just pulled up looking for the pass, but
and you know
timely
Anthony,
shot.
That's been the story all day for Avon. They have easy looks, decide to make it harder on themselves and give it up.
Yeah, that's really been a story of this game.
Avon still with a chance. Down 11. Winfrey setting a screen. Collision rejects it. And Gonzalez takes
wow.
a huge charge.
It's got to be, what, their fourth charge of the game?
And it looks like Collegian slow to get up as well as Gonzalez. Collegian still not back on his feet. Helped up by his teammates, and he's limping.
Yeah, that was a tough fall for him. Just going with full speed, and hopefully he's okay because he's a great player.
Aragot's calling a timeout. Collegian status for the rest of the game up in the air. Avon down by 11 now with 3:17 to go. We'll be right back. My Detroit players, Tim's from my hood again, in Brooklyn. This game may be coming to an end, but we got more action the rest of today. A championship rematch. Hrazdan versus Armenz after this. And after that, we have Artsakh and Erebuni, two teams jockeying for playoff position. As you see the standings, Armenz continuing their undefeated season. They've been great. Beat Artsakh last week in the battle of the two juggernauts. And coming down the stretch, the Armenz are a clear favorite for the championship. Good news for Aragaz. Collegian back on the floor. Looks like he's okay.
He has no choice. They only got 5 players.
At this point, not a lot of choices for Aragaz. You're definitely right.
Gutsy player, too. He's gonna tough it out.
Barsegian with it. Arapetian. Didn't jack it up. Gets it back to Barsegian. 5 on the shot clock. Doesn't finish the finger roll layup. And Anthony, Baski here won't put the game out of reach, but it'll put it damn near.
Absolutely. I mean, Avon basically has to play a perfect game now to even contend for a win.
Legend, sidestep.
Wow, that was a... interesting sidestep, but very effective.
Gonzalez draws the foul. 2:24 now. Remains in the game. 11-point lead for Aragaz.
You know, I'm surprised there hasn't been a full court yet from Avon.
Arapetian working on Kardosh inside Yazigian. Big shot, puts the game back to single digits.
That's the Winfrey effect. I don't even know if Winfrey was going to attempt to block it, but just his presence there makes you think.
Winfrey with it up top. Kashishian now working on the smaller Arapetian. He's off, rebound Avon. And Sean gives a foul in the backcourt. Minute 48 to go. 9-point Aragas lead. Avon needs a huge basket.
Yeah, you got to get a quick three or something over here to kind of cut it down. Not a lot of time left.
Doesn't even have to be a three, just a quick shot.
Yeah, you need something quick, and that's not been the case for Avon today.
Arabetian, right on cue, and one.
That's best case scenario right there. Quick and one, can cut it down to six.
Potentially
minute
six.
30.
And the clock stopped now, which is huge.
Yeah, that's big for them.
Arbetian's 7th point, been quiet offensively, but a great job being a floor general today. Chance to cut it to 6-point lead. And he does just that.
A made free throw by Avon.
Just like that, Anthony, look, they're right back in the game.
Yeah, basically, you got to stop right here. You're right in it.
Cardo sets a screen on Barsegian. Aragas continuing to wind down the clock. Kashishian in the corner. And that one might be the dagger.
That's such a big shot. I mean, fading to his left.
Arabetian driving. Gonzalez. And
oh
one.
Oh, my God. Wow.
And just when Aragats thought they had this one sealed, Avon's coming back roaring.
I said it last time, that last session, but this is the best case scenario. 4-point play. Don't get a technical foul either. That would hurt it even more.
And Gonzalez has been absolutely stellar today. 16 points. Can't make it 17.
Misses the free throw, though.
Still just a 6-point game. Avon going to their bench. Aragats calling a timeout. Going to draw something up. Anthony, who do you think Aragats goes to out of this break?
I think, well, they've been leaning on Collegian a lot in the final couple minutes. I think they're going to do the same. I think with Kashishian shooting, it makes it difficult to defend Collegian. You don't want to help too much. Winfrey has been great, but seems like he's been slowing down the second half. I think they're going to keep it with Collegian and have him create.
And for Avon, a stop is huge. They've gone away from that zone. Aragats has gone away from that zone in the second half, and it's been working a lot better for them.
They've been playing really good man-to-man defense. I think that's been an important part of their success so far. I think, look, you got to get a stop for Avon, and you have to go quick. You have to get a quick shot. That 4-point play was perfect. You missed the free throw, but it starts on the defensive side, and I think, obviously, Aragats is going to take as much time as they can.
59.1 left in the game. It's going to be tough for Avon, but I've seen crazier things happen, Anthony.
Absolutely. You never know what could happen, especially in this game with 5 players. And I'm surprised no one has fouled out yet. No foul outs, no techs. Winfrey's the closest, right?
Winfrey had the early foul trouble, but he's been disciplined since then.
Yeah,
he has 3, but Collegian's going to have to be careful. He does have 4 fouls.
Yeah, I think you got to get a good look. You have to get the best shot possible right now. And that has to go through Collegian, who's been really good at creating offense this game. Don't overthink it. If it's a bad shot, you only take it when there's no time left because you want to get a good shot.
It's been Kashishian the whole way, leading the way for Aragas with 26 points, the catalyst for this team today. Tronis gets it into Kardosh. Avon could play this possession without fouling. The legend caught in a double team. And Avon forces a turnover. Gonzalez bringing it up.
Smart trap right there from Avon. Oh.
Barsegian almost loses it. And Gonzalez can't draw the foul. Winfrey with the rebound.
Manuel doesn't like that one, and I get it.
Great job by Aragas not faltering after throwing that turnover.
Yeah, and I think I get why it's a no call, and I get why it should be a call, but he's trying to create that contact, and I think the refs that one was pretty obvious that he was trying to create contact, and they're not going to reward you.
32 seconds left now. Baronis inbounding again. Collegian winds up with it.
Wasted opportunity though for Avon. They got a steal, and it wasn't even, they didn't even waste a lot of time until then.
Collegian will go to the free throw line. 1 for 3 today. Oh, Collegian not going to the free throw line yet. My apologies. Shishin with it. Just wasting time now.
Surprise, there's no foul here.
Avon not deciding to foul, and Yazidian finally does, but so much time came off the clock. And now Manuel getting warned by the ref.
Yeah, he's asking about the free throws. I guess a foul within 2 minutes is automatic free throws. That's what he's saying.
Avon calls a Aragaz calls a timeout before the ball is brought in. 17.1 left, 6-point lead for them.
It just hasn't been meant to be for Avon.
And Anthony, I think there's one guy we know that he's the reason why it hasn't been the day for Avon.
Greg Kishishin, what a performance today. 26 points, made some timely buckets, had that big corner three. Collegian has been the creator, but Kishishin has been the scorer. He's been just lights out. He started off slow, then he really has been a key player for them today. He's our player spotlight.
And the thing is, we mentioned it, Kishishin not getting baskets the way he usually does, scoring inside the three-point line. He's been a mid-range sniper today.
Yeah, a good variety of buckets. And he was shooting poorly from three. He's only had two 3-point baskets. Imagine if he hit two more of those.
Peronis will inbound again. And look, you can just tell by the demeanor of these Aragaz players, they're really fired up.
Yeah,
especially
they're into
Greg.
And they've been into it the whole game. I think Avon has been they've been a little discouraged. Things haven't gone their way.
Kardosh gets it. Peronis cuts, running away from the foul. Finally gets one.
Smart to not take that layup, but I think this is the best possible person who could foul at this position right now for Aragaz.
Avon's going to need something to go their way. A couple bounces of the ball and some big triples. Peronis off on the first. 13 seconds remain.
You just need one right now. Just need one.
Anthony, I think it goes back to all those missed free throws for Avon.
They add up, man. Because it just adds to your momentum as well.
Iripetian drives. Yazidian finishes. 5-point game. 5.9 on the clock. Ball in. Garoyan gets it. Gonzalez off. And that's going to do it. Aragaz finally sneaks out a win, taking it 79-74 on the back of none other than Greg Kishishian. Kishishian with an excellent performance today.
Big game from him. I think this is a great game overall for Aragaz, fighting with five players. So huge, huge game for them.
The Riding Tutor player of the game coming right after this. And your player of the game is none other than Greg Kishishian. 26 points. Getting things done by the way of the mid-range and not from deep. He was excellent. Also, great job by Collegian getting all of his teammates involved. Winfrey cleaning up everything on the glass today.
Greg,
and now
we're
going
here
down to the sideline with Anthony Garib and Greg Kishishian.
Greg, huge win for you guys. Five players. What was the key?
Just play as a team. Move the ball around. We didn't have subs, so we had to conserve our energy. But at those times that we needed to go, we went.
You weren't hitting a lot of your threes. Did that impact your performance? How are you trying to still contribute without those falling?
Threes aren't falling. You got to do other things. You got to play defense. You got to move the ball. You got to pass. I was just trying to make our team like be cool, calm, collected. Just play basketball. Don't worry about anything else.
I have to ask you about that skyhook. Have you done that? Do you practice that shot?
I don't do anything. I don't practice.
Good answer. Greg Kishishian, player of the game. We'll have more AABA coming soon.